Hello, my dear students. Good afternoon, all of you. How are you all? I hope you all are fine. Welcome back your online classes. I hope you all are remember this all things. So, students, if you forgot, so let's first of all we do the revision and then we start our session. So, before starting our revision, let's see here today's quote. So, now, students. Let's check here what is today's quote. So now, okay, here quote is a beautiful day begins with a beautiful mindset. It means what? Our beautiful day beginning means a start, okay, starting initials. Our day is starting initials with which things with here with a beautiful mindset. We have a first of all what? Mindset. We have a mindset. Today, whole day, we are doing all our study. Today, we are complete our books. Today, we are going to a prayer. Today, we do the namaz. So, student, we have some things in our mind. So, a whole day, we are mindset means a beautiful mindset. We are a set mind, okay? I hope you all are understood. Now, students, I hope you remember all these things, what we have done in previous lecture. I hope you all are understood, okay? What we have done in previous lecture or last lecture. So, students, in last lecture, we have done a revision of chapter number 4. And in chapter number 4, what we have done? Multiplication, looking up back, using array in multiplication, and multiplying by 7. Okay, multiplying by 7 means table number 7. So, again, I am telling you, in last lecture, students, we have done a revision of chapter number 2. What is the multiplication? Then, after multiplication, looking back. Using array in multiplication and then after multiplying by 7 means table number 7. Now today's content, let's check here today's content. So students, today's contents, today we are going to learn again a revision of last sessions. What we have done in last sessions, we are checking here. Okay, so first of all, today we are starting to a revision of last sessions. Then after multiplying by 7, which topic? Multiplying by 7 means table number 7. Then after exercise number 4a, which exercise, students? Exercise number 4a, question number 1st, action exercise. Then after question number 2, complete. And then after question number 3 is compare using what? Compare using greater than, less than, or is equal to means equal to. Question number 1 is what, students? Action exercise. It means there is some model and by the action of model we going to learn. So students, and then question number 2 we are going to learn. Which question number 2 is? What is the name of question number 2? Complete. But who? There is a blank. Okay, then after question number 3. So question number 3 is what? Compare using greater than, less than, or equal to means is equal to that. Understood? So now let's start here the revision of last sessions. Students, in last sessions we have done what? Multiplying by 7 means table number 7. Okay, we know what is a multiply by 7, but again we are do here the revision of multiplying by 7. So now let's check here. You can the 6 time tables very well. Which table we know? We know the table number 6. Again we are repeating here. 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12, 6 twos are 12, 6 3s are 18, 6 4s are 24, 6 5s are 13, 6 6s are 36, 6 7s are 42, 6 8s are 48, 6 9s are 54, and 6 10s are 60. So, I hope you remember all students table number 6. So, they told us you know the 6 time tables very well. What? You know the 6 timetables very well. Very well. Okay, students, let's check here. One more things. First of all, we starting our revision, we starting our new things, sessions, exercise, whatever. So I think you are taking your book that time. What? So now, first of all, students, you take your book, rough book, either you have a, if you have a textbook, so you take a textbook, and then after you have compulsory, you take a rough book. And some noticeable point and some very important point, if you are forgot this point, so you have must be right. Okay, whenever you important points are coming, so I am telling you, I am say students, please write in your rough book. Okay, or some sort calculation, some sorts method and some easy method, so you compulsory do in your rough book. Understood? Daily in daily math lecture, you have should be keep with your rough book. Okay, I hope you all are understood, and I hope you take a book. Okay, so now you have in front of table number 6. Okay, so you are give a properly answer. We first of all, you see a table number 6 and then you give a better answer. Got my points? So students, now let's check here. You know the 6 time tables very well. So again, I'll repeat you. 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12, 6 threes are 18, 6 fours are 24, 6 fives are 30, 6 sixes are 36, 6 sevens are 42, 6 eights are 48, 6 nines are 54, and 6 tens are 16. Understood, all students? So we know very well table number 6, means 6 time tables. And you also know the order properties of multiplication. Which type of order? 6 ones are. So it's an order property. In first row, 6 2 6 1 2 10 is common, as like that. 6 ones are, 6 twos are. Okay, so it's a after ordering. Okay, which type of order? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10, it's called order. So 6 ones are, 6 twos are, 6 threes are, 6 fours are, 6 fives are, 6 sixes are, 6 sevens are, 6 eights are, 6 nines are, and 6 it's what? Order property of multiplication. So then when you are learn the 7 time tables, you learn only 3 new multiplication fact. What we are learned that time? Okay, and how can it possible? I am telling you here. So you learn only 3 new multiplication fact, which how many? 3 new multiplication facts. Okay, so now let's check here. Here are so many books, but in this is first group of book, second group of book, third book of group, and here fourth group of book, and here 5, 6, and 7. Here 7 group of books. Okay, and in all group and each group, how many books are there? So now let's count here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. How many books are there here? See here. Here, how many groups? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. 7 groups, and each group has 7 books. Understood? See here. 7 groups totally are here. 7 group of books, and each group has 7 books. Understood? Here, let's check here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So 7 books. Here 7 number, 7, 7. So how can it possible? 7, 7. 7 group, and each group has how many books? 7 groups. So 7, 7. So how many? 49. 7, 7 are 49. See now, 7 groups of 7 are what? Books. 7 groups of 7. Groups of 7 are books. Okay, so 7, 7 are 7, 7 are 49. Got my point, students? And here is what a flower vase. Okay, so flower pot or flower vase. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, or 8. Now let's count here. Seventh flower vase is here. How many vases here? seven flower vases. Okay, and each group and each vase is how many flowers in that? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. See here. Here 8 vases. See 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, or 8. 8 vases are here, and each flower vase is in a 7 flowers. Opposite things. Okay. See 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 flower vases in all. Okay, and in all vases are a 7 flowers. So how can we solve here 8 flower vases into all 7 flowers? So 8 sevens are, okay, 56. 8 sevens are 56. Understood? 8 group of 7 are, okay, so 8 sevens are 56. I hope you all are understood. Now we move on other. Okay, what we have learned? 7 sevens are, okay, so first we learn 7 sevens are 49, then we learn what 7 eights are 56, and then we learn 7 nines are how many old students? 63. But how can it possible? See, here is your favorite food. Okay, I think you have a very, you like this fruit. Okay, this is a grapes. So I hope you all are understood. Now grapes is okay. How many group of grapes here? So let's count here. First, second, third, fourth, five, six, seven, eight, and nine. How many groups are here? There are 7 groups. How many groups? There are 7 groups. No, there are 9 groups. How many? 9 groups. Okay, so you mention in your rough book now, all students. Here is 9 group. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Students, here is total 9 group. But in all groups of grapes, how many grapes are there? So now let's count here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or 7. Okay, in total 9 groups, and each group has 7 grapes. Okay, 9 groups of 7s are which grapes? Okay, all students, in how many groups are here? Here totally 9 groups are there. 9 groups are there, and each group has how many grapes? 7 grapes. Each group has 7 grapes. Understood? Got my point, all students? So 9 multiplied by 7 means 7 nines or 9 sevens. So now we are learn here what? We are learn here a 7 nines. 7 nines how many, all students? 63. Okay, 7 nines are 63. Got my point? So we have learned here 7 sevens are 49, then after 7 eights are 56, then after 7 nines are 63. Understood? And now we learn here total a full sum of what? Here we are going to learn table number 7. Okay, now attention here, all students, and all table number 7 you are right in your rough book now. Okay, so here I'll put here the space. Okay, here you should have to write answer here and here, both place. Understood, all students? So students, first of all, you write this as like that. No need to draw these all models, only you should be write these seven times tables. Okay, this and this. Okay, I am speaking here and you are mentioning in your blanks rough. Okay, so first of all you write, take your times. 1 sevens are 7, 2 sevens are 14, 3 sevens are. Okay, but that time you put a blank empty space. Okay, and then we are going to learn, revise. That time you should be right. Okay, that time I am saying you. that time I'm say okay, and then after you should be write this. Okay, so first of all you write the 3 7s, 4 7s, 5 7s, 6 7s, 7 7s. Then after 8 7s, 9 7s, and 10 7s. Okay, so you, I think you wrote with me. It means as like what? Now I'm speaking, that time you are writing in your book. Understood? So now then first of all you complete this thing, then after you writing using the order property. Now you should be write in your fair book all students, compulsory. 7 1s are 7, 7 2s are 14, then after 7 3s are how many? 21, 7 4s are 28, 7 5s are 35, 7 6s are 42, 7 7s are 49, 7 8s are 56, and 7 9s are 63, and 7 10s are 70. Got my points? Again I am repeating you. Okay, but first of all we complete this thing. 7 1s are 7, 1 7s are 7, opposite things. 2 7s are 14. Here how many here one things here, how many models? 1 2, here 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 and 10. But in each chain has how many beats? There is 7 beats. Okay, in each chain, and each chain how many beats are there? There are 7 beats. Got my point? So no need to draw these all things, we have to write only these things. Okay, 2 7s are 14, 3 7s are 21, 4 7s are 28, sorry, 3 7s are 21, and 4 7s are 28, and 5 7s are 35, and 6 7s are 42, 7 7s are 49, 8 7s are 56, and 9 7s are 63, and then after 10 7s are 17. Understood all students? I hope you all are understood, and you are now you are writing in your book. Then after 7 1s are 7, 7 2s are 14, 7 3s are 21, then after 7 4s are 28, 7 5s are 35, 7 6s are 42, 7 7s are 49, 7 8s are 56, and 7 9s are 63, and last one 7 10s are 70. I hope you all are understood, and I hope you all wrote a table in your book. Understood? Now we move on exercise number 4A. Which exercise? We have left the exercise number 4A. So I hope you all are remember. I hope you all are remember the tables. Okay, on the basis of table we are solving here, we are solve here the exercise. Students, let's start here the exercise number 4A. So now what is exercise number 4A? Let's check here exercise number 4A, action exercise. Okay, Shankar build the 7 timetables using a straw and counting the place where they are crossed. Okay, so the question number 1 is what? Action exercise is a basis on a basis or a related to the 7 timetables. I hope you all are remember the 7 timetables. Again I am repeating you here table number 7. 7 1s are 7, 7 2s are 14, 7 3s are 21, 7 4s are 28, 7 5s are 35, 7 6s are 42, 7 7s are 49, 7 8s are 56, 7 9s are 63, and 7 10s are 17. Understood? So always you are remember these all things and keep it in your mind. Table number 17. Here a name of boy, Shankar. Shankar built the 7 timetables. He is built the 7 timetables using the straw. Further example, we are show the chain and beats, and here what Shankar using here a straw. Okay, straw. Okay, by straw what you are doing? By straw you are suck juice, water, any your favorite things, milkshake, whatever. So straw and counting the place where they cross. Okay, Shankar built the seven timetables using a straw and counting the place where they cross. Understood? So now let's check here. Okay, here let's check one by one also here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. How many straws are here? Here red, blue, orange, green, violet or orange means, and then here pink and again yellow. Understood? So here how many straws are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. This is all cross and one is cross only. See here, this orange is one only cross. So students, here is 7 straws. How many straws are here? 7 row. So we wrote the 7 and 1 straw is standing. This one. Okay, so we wrote here, we write here the 1. So 1 7's are 7 1's are 7 or 1 7's are 7. I hope you all are understood. Got my point all students? I hope you all are understood. Got my point? 1 7's are 7 and 7 1's are 7. But how can it possible? So is this possible as like that here? How many straw is 1 straw? And then here 1 multiply, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So 7's are 7 and 7 1's are 7. Then after as like same here, how many straws? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. How many old students? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Again, let's start recounting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. And 7 multiplied by 1 and 2. Okay, got my point. As like that. Recounting now old students. 1, 2. So 2 multiply by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So 2 multiply by 7. It means 2 7s are 14 or 7 2s are 14. Got my point all students? I hope you all are understood. Now then compare the table by drawing lines in your notebook like this. What? Here are so many small circles. Okay, so here we no need to perform this. Understood all students? So complete the tables by drawing lines in your notebook. Okay, but here we are not draw in our book. Only just we are learn by orally. So students, question number 1 is done and question number 1 we are not writing in our fair book. What I am telling you again, I'll two times repeating you for you. Question number 1, exercise number 4a, question number 1 we are not repeating here. We are not writing in our fair book. Okay, see this question, we are not writing in our fair book. Directly we write the question number 2. So let's check here. What is the question number 2? I hope you all are understood. What is the question number 2? So let's check here the question number 2. Question number 2 is complete. Okay. I hope you all are remember in 1 week. How many days are come all students in 1 week? 7 days are come. Okay, in 1 week are in 1 week is equal to 7 days. But how can it possible? So Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday and Sunday. Okay, as like that. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday and Sunday. So Monday is 1, Tuesday is 2, Wednesday is 3rd, Thursday is 4, Friday is 5, Saturday is 6 and Sunday is 7. So how many days are total in week? 7 days are in week. So 8 week is equal to how many days? So here we are using table number 7 or table number 8. Okay, so we should be right. 8 weeks is equal to how many days? So how can we know? So we know in 1 week is equal to 7 days. 1 week is equal to 7 days. So 8 week and 7 days, we are multiplying here. Understood? So 8 sevens are 56. How many old students? 8 sevens are 56. I hope you all are understood. 8 sevens are 56. Then after we write answer as like 56. Then after question number B is what? 9 weeks is equal to how many days? So 1 week is equal to how many days, all students? 7 days. 1 week is equal to 7 days. So 7 days multiply by 9. So 7 nines are we have learned? 63. 7 nines are 63. Okay, so answer is what? 63 days. 9 sevens are 63. Okay, here 8 sevens are 56 days. Okay, in 8 week is equal to 56 days. So in 8 week, total 56 days. Okay, and then after here 9 weeks is equal to 63 days. Understood? Got my points? I hope you all are understood. And this all question you have to write now in your rough book. Write. Okay. Now we are starting here the question number 3. What is the question number 3? Exercise number 4A, question number 3, compare using a greater than, less than, or equal to, means is equal to. Okay, I hope you will we know what is a greater than, what is a less than, and what is a equal to or is equal to. We have learned in chapter number 1. Okay, so now directly we start the question number 1. Question number 1 is what? 7 multiplied by 7 dash circle. Then 15. So we should be right here, we should be put here, we should be compare here. This side, this number is bigger. Okay, then after we are decide what we are putting here, greater than or less than. So here 7 multiplied by 7, here 50. But we are do here 7, 7. Okay, 7, 7 is 49. How many? 7, 7 is 49. See this, 7, 7 is 49 and here is 15. So which number is big here? 40, here is 49, here and 50. So which sign is big here? This side, greater than. Okay, greater than. Understood all students? So we put here the greater than. Got my point all students? Now question number B. Question number B is what? 7 multiplied by 7. 7, 7 is how many? 49 and here 7 2s are. See here 7 7s are 49. 7 7s are 49 and here 7 2s are. 7 1s are 7 and 7 2s are 14. So students, let's check here 49 and 14. See here 49 and 1 4 14. So which number is here big? Which number is big here? So we put this sign. Okay, this these numbers are bigger, highest this side, this cross sign we are putting, and this number are big, that time we are put as a crocodile mouth is open. Crocodile mouth we are open, we are put the number are bigger. Understood all students? Got my point? So 49 is bigger than to 14. Understood? Then after question number C. Question number C is what? 0 7s are. And this side is 7. Okay, so 0 7s are 0 and 7. Okay, so how can it come? How can it possible? Because of we know. We have learned these things. Before starting our chapter multiplication, we know one thing. Now I am telling you what we have learned that time. We have learned 0, any digit multiply with 0. See, any digit multiply with 0, so we get a 0. Okay, any number we multiply with 0, so we get 0. Understood? So here 0 and 7. So which number is big? 7. So we put a here. Understood? We put here. Okay, this side is a small, so we crocodile mouth is open, is a bigger side, a largest number. Then after question number D, 7 plus 7 and here 7 multiplied by 7. 7 plus 7, 7 plus 7, so how many all students see here? 7 plus 7 is equal to 14, and here 7 multiplied by 7 means 7 sevens how many? 49. 7 sevens are 49. So 14 is bigger or 49 is bigger? 49 is bigger. So 49 is bigger than 214. So here we are put this side. Understood? Then after last question, question number E. 7 multiply by 1. 7 multiply by 1. And here 7. So 7 ones how many? 7. Okay. Any number multiply with 1. Any number multiply with 1. So answer is multiply, multiplication product is itself. 7 multiply by 7. Sorry, 7 multiply by 1. So 7 sevens are 7. So here what is equal to? Equal to. Okay. So 7 and 7 here both are equal. So we are put here with sign. Is equal to means equal to. I hope you all are understood and this all things you have write in your rough book. Okay. Today's your homework is to the today's your homework is exercise number 4th, A, question number 2 and 3. You should be right in your fair book one time. And one time in your rough book. I hope you all are understood. Okay, now one more thing here. Please, students, wear a face mask. Whenever you are outside at your home, so wear a face mask. Practice social distancing and do not enter if you are feel sick. Any place. Understood? Thank you so much, all of you. Thank you all.